In 2015, Johnson & Johnson surpassed the targets that we set to support our commitment to the MDGs, through every woman, every child. And like the rest of the global health community, we were both pleased and disappointed with the progress that we collectively made to reach the MDGs. With more than 5.9 million children still dying before their fifth birthday, we have a long way to go, and more than half of those are newborns. So in our SDG commitment, some things are going to look really familiar to those of you in the room who are our partners. We remain committed as ever to working through partnerships. Women and children are part of our DNA at Johnson & Johnson, and their health is important to both our businesses and our social impact work. And we still view women and children's health as a continuum with challenges and solutions at every area of that circle, from the pregnant woman to the newborn to the child to the adolescent and all the way back around the circle. But this commitment looks a little bit different in the how. How do we plan to meet these goals? We're doing some new things, like mobilizing our employees. You can imagine the enthusiasm, the skills, and the ingenuity harbored in more than 130,000 employees around the world. We're discovering new ways to address local health challenges through things like the GenH Challenge. And it's a competition that it's really built on the premise that a new idea can bubble up from anybody, anywhere. Anyone can be an innovator. And we're reinforcing our regional teams and working harder to deliver locally driven partnerships. We're exploring new ways to accelerate social change through impact investing. So these are all maybe some ideas that we had done a little bit of work in the past, but we're really prioritizing the new how we get this done.